Hello, my name is Abdel-Rahman, and today I would like to demonstrate you using the G user code, which is part of the EGSnrc Monte Carlo code. With G, that code is used to calculate one specific quantity, which is the radiation fraction for photon beams. As you're aware, photon beams, when they interact, or a photon when it interacts with matter, it may undergo interaction with photoelectric, Compton, Rayleigh pair production, and maybe triplet production. Some of these interactions, energy will be transferred to charged particles. That will be for photoelectric, Compton, and pair and triplet production. Now, the charged particles, which are dominantly electrons, but in case of pair and triplet, we may get also positrons. These charged particles will then undergo interactions with the medium. And in their interactions with the medium, they may lose their energy through collisions. So that's collisional interactions. Or they may lose their energy through radiative losses or Bramstein. So the G quantity, the radiation fraction for photon beams is basically the ratio of the energy absorbed, or the energy of the charged particles produced by the photon beam that is actually converted back into photons. So that would be in case of Bramstein line, or in case if we have positrons, the positron may undergo in-flight annihilation. So the energy that was initially given to this positron, the positron did not dissipate it into collisional interactions in medium, but part of that energy is going to be lost if the positron undergoes in-flight annihilation. Of course, if the positron loses all of its energy and then it undergoes annihilation at the end of its track, after it lost all of its energy, then no energy that was given to the positron converted back to photons. So in order, this quantity could be theoretically speaking, could be actually calculated knowing the cross sections for the different photon interactions. That will depend on the photon energy as well as on the medium of interaction, and then we use the radiation yield for electrons that were produced. So it's really a messy calculation. With Monte Carlo, we can actually simulate this interactions of photons with matter, and then we can track down the amount of energy first transferred to charged particles, and then track down how much of that energy is then converted into photons in the form of Bramstein or in-flight annihilation. So the G code actually does this thing in particular. So let me show you how the G code works. The G code does not have a graphical user interface, a GUI, but we need to then go and modify the script. So first thing we need to go is to the home area, and you should find a code called G. Probably, if this is the first time you're using the code, probably it's not compiled. So to compile it, we'll just type make. And then the code is going to be compiled. Okay, so now we need to modify the, there should, in that directory, there should be a template, a G template, EGSNI, EGSNI IP file. So let's, I'm gonna make a copy, so I'm gonna just play with the copy. So let's copy G template, and let me make something, the naming of something useful. I will try to calculate it for the G, the radiation fraction for air, for let's say 1 MeV photons. Okay, so I'm gonna put it like this, and then at the end input. Okay, now it's the time to modify to see what's there in this input file. So I'm gonna open it now. Okay, so this template has you know, a lot of, you know, has good documentation, but the first section here, this describes the physics. Of course, if you want to spend or to use actually the latest or more accurate physics, then we probably need to modify these parameters. So for example, I know that spin effects, we should turn this on. Bound content, probably I would like to use that, although it might not really be that important. But it's just a habit from my side to try to use the most accurate physics. Atomic relaxation, I'm going to turn that on, and though that's probably not relevant, but as a habit, I'm going to turn it on. And pair angular sampling, maybe you can turn this on, and you can play with this. It's so the spin effects that is off, and okay, I see it's duplicated here in the template, so probably we don't need this line. Okay, so that takes care of the physics. Now the next section here, this is the media. So the media is air. So you just have to make sure, I mean, this is the name of the media in the PEX file. And as I have shown you in a previous video, how to calculate this file and to, you know, to add to it the cross sections of a particular media and so on. So that my naming convention, I think a lot of people use the same convention, is they put just an abbreviation of what the material is, and then 521, this is the AE parameter that was used to generate the PEX data file, and that's basically defines the cutoff for the restricted collision stopping powers. And then ICRU, initial random number seeds, I'm going to leave that alone. The number of history, okay, I'm going to leave the default, I'm not going to play with that. And that's it. Then if we go down, further down, this is the source definition. So the source incident charge, incident charge is a photon, so that will be zero. And I don't want to use a spectrum, but I want to use a mono-energetic beam. So I will comment these two lines. And then here, this is if I have a, I'm gonna uncomment these two lines because I want to define the photon source, the energy of it, to be a mono-energetic. But I will change the energy here. Remember, the energies are in MeV. So I'm gonna put 1 MeV here. There are some other options. You can look at these options if you wish to define different type of source energies. And I think that's it. Okay. This is, I think this is in the case if we're using a PEGless media definition. So I'm gonna leave it, but I'm actually going to use medium defined from a PEX data file. So now we can save the file. And the next thing is we're going to execute it, run it. So the command is EX. This is in Linux, Windows. I'm not sure, Windows probably, maybe the EX format of command execution Doesn't work there, but there is another option how you can execute codes with Windows. That's explained in the documentation. So EX and then the code name, which is G, and then the input file, mine is going to be air. I'm going to remove the extension, and then the PEX data file. PEX data file, I'm going to use the default data PEX data file that comes with the system, and then I execute, and you see that the code is being executed. So essentially the output, the data output, is actually on this page, or the results. So you will find here this line first, for 1 MeV photons, the average energy transferred to electrons is 27 keVs actually. And out of that, the energy lost out of this energy is very, very small. It's 6.294, okay? And that is only due to Bramshallan. But the other third line is the average energy loss to all radiation. So that will include Bramshallan as well as in-flight annihilation. Now for 1 MeV, we know pair production and triple production cannot occur. And that's why the energy loss of all radiation is going to be equal to exactly that lost to Bramshallan. So this is the G fraction. The G fraction is then, it's this is the value of it, okay? And that's only from Bramshallan, and the G fraction from all radiation, it's about 0.002. So based on this, for example, so the energy transfer, all what this states is that for 1 MeV photons, the energy, the average energy transfer to per particle is 27 keV. And the Bramshallan fraction out of this is about 0.02%. That is for air. Now, let's change the material. So I'm going to copy the file. Okay, and let's do it for high Z material. So let's do it for lead. Lead. And then also 1 MeV, and we'll put the extension, okay? And now we will edit this file. So the physics part remains the same. I need to only change this medium, so that will be PB, okay? And let's execute now the code. It's going to take a longer time because PB a bit longer. So we'll wait till it finishes. You can find graphs of the G. So let's look at this is a graph. This is from the book Radiation Physics for Medical Physicists. Published or written by Dr. Erwin Podgorzek. And so here, this is the G, the mean radiation fraction, G, as a function of energy for different materials. So for 1 MeV, you see for carbon, it's something very, very small. I think it's about 0.2, 0.002, roughly around that. So air is going to be somewhere in this location here. So for lead, we're going to expect a value close to this 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, I think maybe roughly around 0.05, so about 5%. So we'll check what are the results from the Monte Carlo simulation. So here is here are the results. Again, this is the average energy per release per particle, and that's the energy loss due to Bramshall-Lange, and the energy loss to all radiation. Again, from all radiation and Bramshall-Lange, the values are the same, because pair production cannot occur at 1 MeV. And the G value, so the Bramshall-Lange is 0.053, so that's about 5%. So basically, whatever energy at 1 MeV is given to the charged particles, electrons and positrons, we expect 5% of that energy to be converted back into X-rays, Bramshall-Lange X-rays, essentially Bramshall-Lange. So let's now change the energy, okay, instead of 1 MeV. So we're going to do it for a higher energy. So we're in section for energy, it's here. So now we're going to do it for 10 MeV. In 10 MeV, we expect pair production to happen, and thus we are going to get energy loss due to in-flight annihilation of positrons, and we should expect that the values are not going to be identical for G all versus and G radiative. So let's okay, I should have actually copied the file, but and may rename it to 10 MeV, but that's fine. Okay, so let's execute it again, and this is going to take a long time. So now the simulation has finished, and took about 500 close to 10 minutes. And again, what we look at is here. So we can, this is the Bramshall-Lange fraction, this is about 24%, or the radiation fraction due to Bramshall-Lange only is about 24%. And if we take all radiation lost, that is Bramshall-Lange, as well as in-flight annihilation of positrons, it's a bit higher. So these numbers are different now, because some energy was lost through in-flight annihilation. So I hope this is a this was a useful demonstration of how to use the G user code. And thank you very much.